Whoa.
It begins.
Here we go.
Two!
There's the way through!
There's something.
Thank you.
To work it is! I see. Just wanted to stare into my eyes.
Thank you. happened?
Save time.
So what'd you find out there? Whatever.
Follow my lead.
Say the word.
Yeah.
I see the way up.
You met the boy, of course.
Back!
Now.
Whatever you say. save time.
Let's get to it. Now, what else do I want to tell you?
Prepare yourself, boy.
Yes, sir.
Behind you!
that. Another gate opened up.
Oh!
easier every time, right? There's the way through! Gate open!
It begins.
Here we go. Draugr, behind you!
You've gotten pretty good at that.
Journey awaits.
Okay, then.
Okay, what's good?
Good.
I ought to keep them from hacking bits off you. What were we talking about?
Have you no respect for my time? Whatever.
Let's sort you out. Next time.
That's it? Beautiful Gondul? No story or anything?
Sorry, lad. The sight of Gondul always took my breath away. Gondul had a silver tongue, a sharp wit, and struck a figure so stunning it literally drove men insane. Odin forbid her from setting foot in Midgard after a time, as insanity is not a welcome trait in Valhalla. This is none other than Geirdrifol, the master of arms in Valhalla, responsible for arming and training Odin's Einherjar.
His what?
His army, come Ragnarok. The entire reason Valhalla exists, you see. The Einherjar wait in the Great Hall endlessly, feasting, drinking, and fornicating themselves silly. Once Ragnarok begins, Odin calls them into service to fight on his behalf. Geirdrifol had her hands full training that lot. This is Rota, a chooser of the slain.
I thought all the Valkyrie did that.
Not exactly, lad. Although that is what they're most famous for, and by far their greatest responsibility. You've seen what happens to the dead without the judgment of the Valkyries.
Hellwalkers.
That's right. Rota, Gunnar, Skuld. Without them to clean up the aftermath of battle, Hell overflows with souls meant for Valhalla. A sorry state of affairs. Rota must be beside herself. Here we have Eir, the healer.
A Valkyrie healer? Strange.
Eir was strange, as a matter of fact. Very quiet, very calm. Where her sisters were violent rapids, Eir was a gentle stream. She healed the wounds of both mortals and gods, and even a certain all-knowing sage who once drank too much and fell off a mountain. Not my proudest moment. Well, Hildr, mistress of battle. She and Odin got on quite well, actually. Her and the other Valkyries, not so much. She would spend most of her time here in Midgard observing discord between the living, and sewing some up herself from time to time. She lived for conflict. Some say she was conflict personified. I wonder what will become of her now that she's free. Olwyn, once the daughter of a powerful chieftain, she fell defending him during a Reaver attack. Olwyn was escorted to Valhalla, where she chose to devote her afterlife to the pursuit of knowledge above all else. Quite unusual behaviour amongst the constant drinking and feasting of her fellow Valhallian denizens.
How'd she end up a Valkyrie?
Odin. He saw a kindred spirit in Olrun's single-minded pursuit of knowledge. He appointed her as the Valkyrie's resident historian.
Please, walk it off! Radatastar, save the day! Again.
No! Thank you, friends. You have saved the Valkyries.
Sigrun, how did this happen?
Mimir, is that you? You have been freed, but...
Freedom comes at a price, milady.
You speak truly. Countless winters we serve the Allfather. But only through his union to the Queen did we ever taste some measure of freedom.
But aren't you the Queen?
There has only been one Queen of the Valkyries, the goddess Freya. When Odin severed her wings, I served in her absence, but it wasn't enough for the Allfather. He used an archaic piece of magic, corrupting my sisters. I tried to contain the damage by imprisoning them in places where they could cause no harm, but soon I lost myself as well.
Sigrun, I'm sorry for being so worthless. I could have done something, or tried at the very least. What will you do now?
I must reunite with my sisters. Together we can restore balance to the realms. You have the eternal blessings of the Valkyries.
Well, we did it, I suppose.
You don't sound very happy about it.
It's difficult to be happy about anything when you're a reanimated head. I'm grateful we were able to set the Valkyries free. But so much of this could have been avoided, if only...
You said it yourself, head. It does not matter anymore. The past is the past.
Well, that's awfully cheerful coming from you.
I am in a good mood. The dwarves will make use of this helm.
Your dad's a wee bit single-minded, isn't he, lad?
Definitely.
Is the Valkyrie Queen? She never told us. You never told us.
Explain yourself, head. Or are you bewitched again?
Not at all. Freya was Queen of the Valkyries at one point. Part of her marriage dowry included overseeing the Valkyries themselves. As a powerful Vanir goddess, they revered her. I never knew how much until now.
Whoa.
Let's sort you out. Was that all there is?
brothers, there's another thing I must let you know from the time you were away in Jotunheim.
Well, tell us then.
It concerns Freya. She paid me a visit.
What did you tell her?
What little I know about where Odin may have kept her Valkyrie wings. Seems she's rather bent on reclaiming her warrior spirit. I'm afraid the cycle of vengeance may not be so easily broken.
Time to rest.
I'm gonna sleep through winter.
Okay, this'll do.
Sleep.
Way ahead of you.
Atreus, are you ready?
Yeah, but I had the weirdest dream. Fimbulwinter was ending, and Thor came for us, here at the house.
It was only a dream.
But it felt different. It felt real. It felt like the future.
Then we will worry about it tomorrow. Today, there are still things we can do. Come.
Here we go!
Find the edge, boy.
Should we be here?
Look here. Another.
Oh, look! It's Skoll and Hati, the giant wolves who chase the sun and moon.
Quite right, my boy.
Where did they come from? How did they get up there?
That's a long story. You'll get to it.
What's happening there at the end? They eat the sun and moon? And then everybody fights?
I suppose that's one way to put it.